Then in 1995, it received one of sport's highest honors. Snowboarding was to become part of the Olympic Games. Thousands came to Mount Yakabatai in Japan for snowboarding's coming out party. Its first Olympic event, the men's giant slalom. Canada's best hopes in Japan rested with that team. It was loaded with talent. Ross Rebliati was considered to be one of the world's best racers. The Whistler BC native had struggled to find his winning form during the season, but saved the biggest run of his life for the Olympics.
Okay, we're coming up to the split. There it is, 0.21 seconds faster than the top rider to this point. Still lots of riders to come, though.
That's a good shot right there. Shows you in that point of view shot just how fast they're going. And he came into that turn very well set up and slightly ahead. So Ross, if he can hold it together, and he's fighting it right now for all it's worth. If he can hold it together, he could be in there. So at the end of the last few gates, sets it down a bit, but doesn't scrub too much speed.
Well, he's not holding back.
One gate left to go.
Oh, and time. Ross Rebliati of Whistler, British Columbia, takes over the lead.
I'm exhilarated. I'm kind of speechless right now. I don't know what to say. I'm just glad everyone's watching back home, and all my friends. My dad's here, and I've got a lot of friends on tour wishing me good luck and everything. It's just a beautiful experience.
Rebliati would go down in history as the winner of snowboarding's very first Olympic medal. But just 72 hours after Ross's gold medal run, the sweet taste of victory turned sour.
The results of the testing of sample A revealed the presence of marijuana metabolites.
Minute traces of marijuana were found in Rebliati's system. The substance isn't banned by the Olympic Committee, but is by the International Ski Federation, which administers the sport. The Canadian was stripped of his gold medal and banned from the games. The Canadian Olympic Association would fight that decision.
We have already begun the appeal process. As in Atlanta, the Court of Arbitration is sitting here in Nagano, so we have the opportunity for a very quick appeal.
The Canadian team would appeal the disqualification, arguing that the Olympic Committee had no agreement with the Ski Federation on the use of marijuana. In addition, it believed that Ross hadn't smoked pot in nearly a year, and that any marijuana found in his system must be from secondhand smoke. Rebliati was to face the court of last resort.
Hi, Sylvia, it's Dave.
Did you hear anything?
A little more than 24 anxious hours after Rebliati was stripped of his medal, the Court of Arbitration handed down its decision.
It's overturned.
Overturned.
While Canadians celebrated Rebliati's victory, Ross himself was in a Japanese police station answering questions about his drug background. When he emerged, he was holding his gold medal.
The most important thing was to have the support of my country and my friends, my family. And the worse things got, the more support they gave me. And that was a surprise to me. I wasn't sure how everyone was going to accept the decisions that they made and the reasons why they had to make them. But as it turned out, the worse it got, the better it got.
First-time Olympic sport, snowboarding certainly grabbed more than its fair share of headlines. It showed it hasn't yet completely shed its young, rebellious image. Snowboarding will certainly be remembered for creating one of the most eventful